hell do you think you're doing?
Shopping.
Yeah, well, you're gonna have to pay for all this stuff.
Hey, no problem. Just give me all the money in your cash register.
Are you nuts?
Do I look like I'm nuts?
No.
And I'd like a pack of Morley menthols. The hard pack. Lonnie, wake up.
What? What's wrong? What?
I just had the worst dream.
Uh-huh.
I didn't even tell you what the dream was. I robbed a convenience store. And then as I was leaving, I stole a red sports car.
Really? With a stick shift?
I think so. I don't know.
Could it have been a German car?
I don't know. I don't remember. Well, the point is...
Could it have been a Porsche?
Just forget about the car, all right? The weird thing is, I was with Shirley the other day, and we were having lunch, and we were talking about exciting things to do, and I jokingly said something about committing a crime, and... Well, that must be why I had the dream.
I heard the screams and I instinctively dove in. The water was so murky, I could barely see my hand in front of my face. I guess I just got lucky because I managed to save both boys and their dog from drowning, and then I administered CPR to all three. Then we took him to Children's Hospital. Well, not the dog, but...
Right.
That's where I work. I specialize in prenatal heart surgery.
That's an incredible story.
I'm sure you have dozens of incredible stories.
Well... Emphasis on the incredible part. So what's life like when you're not working at the hospital?
Well, when I'm not working, I donate time to Doctors Without Borders. You sure you don't want to try this? It's fantastic.
Oh, no. God, I'm positive. If I eat chocolate, I might as well just apply it directly to my hips. What?
I can't get over the fact that you're a police officer.
Why is that so hard to believe?
Well, most people wouldn't put police officer and beautiful in the same sentence. Oh my God, look at me. I'm talking the whole time. It's a typical first date. I apologize.
No. There's nothing to apologize for. Your
check's in. Did you have a small mixed green salad?
Yeah.
Okay, yours comes to $11.50. That was a joke.
City is in the middle of a crime spree. Common thread being the perpetrators are all normal people with normal jobs and no previous criminal history. Jonathan, you find that amusing?
No. Well, it's just that every time a so-called normal person gets arrested, when the reporters interview the neighbors, they always say he was a quiet guy who kept to himself, when statistically speaking, these quote-unquote normal people are 32% more likely to be pushy loudmouths who stick their noses in everyone's business.
Just yesterday, a CPA carjacked a minivan filled with rabbis. An 83-year-old grandmother bungee jumped off of the Hancock building, and a Cubs fan was the victim of a drunken shooting by a player.
Not slamming Sammy.
Obviously, we're looking at some kind of parasitic link that takes control over the host body.
Do we know what kind of parasite?
Well, no.
Do we know how to contain it?
No.
Well, do we know how it moves from one person to the next?
No.
Well, then why is it obvious we're dealing with a parasite?
It's Jonathan's theory. It makes the most sense, and I'm going with it. This time. Now, all the crimes fit a pattern, except for one yesterday. A liquor store robbery where the suspect was described as being nearly 4 foot tall and seemed to know what he was doing.
4 foot one.
Carl!
I wasn't anywhere near there, sir.
Near where?
Wherever it is you're talking about.
I'm going to overlook that because we need your help on this case. We know you're friendly with the parasite community.
Professional courtesy.
Work your contacts, see what you can find. Carl, I don't want to have this armed robbery conversation again.
You and me both, sir.
Dismissed.
So, how was your lunch date?
He's amazing. Did I tell you he once sang the national anthem at a Cubs game?
Are you sure this guy's completely heterosexual?
That's so offensive.
Yeah, I know, and politically incorrect, but a valid question nonetheless. He's too perfect.
Yeah, I don't know. I kept waiting for the other shoe to drop. You know, he's married, he's emotionally unavailable, he's...
Gay?
No, he's not gay. How am I going to have a relationship with someone? I can't even be honest about what I do.
Well, first you have to be honest with yourself.
What does that mean?
Nothing.
Oh, come on, you got something to say? Say it.
You know, you can be a little repressed at times.
Oh, okay. Unlike you, who doesn't have an urge or feeling that isn't acted on. I mean, you want to go to Mardi Gras for the weekend, you go. You want to take flying lessons, you take them. You want to go snowboarding in August, you figure out a way.
What's your point?
Well, that with me, that there are sides that you don't necessarily get to see. Okay, and for once, don't say what you're thinking.
Fine. So how did you leave it with Dr. Perfect?
I'm waiting for him to call.
I thought you liked him.
I do. I do like him more than anyone in a long time.
All right, this is what you need to do.
Oh, great. Coming from someone who's never had a relationship that's outlasted the expiration date on a gallon of milk.
Call him.
What?
I'm probably breaking all kinds of confidentiality agreements by telling you this, but men like it when chicks take control.
Chicks?
That's right, chicks. That's how we talk when you're not around. So if you really want to see Dr. Marvelous again, you'll call him. And don't tell him I told you to do this. I can get into all kinds of trouble with the Guy Guild.
The Guy Guild.
Remember, mum's the word.
You have to believe me. I'm innocent. I can understand why the police think I did it.
Well, they did have surveillance video from 6 different angles.
Did you feel okay when you went to bed last night?
I felt fine.
Did you do anything different? Eat anything different? Anything out of the ordinary?
Well, I did have a glass of wine after dinner.
You make physical contact with anyone other than your husband?
Nothing. I keep thinking I'm gonna wake up and this nightmare is gonna be over. I didn't do it.
For what it's worth, we believe you're innocent.
Thank you.
So listen, if you can think of anything you might have forgotten, any little detail, just give us a call, okay?
These are her belongings.
Thank you.
All right, come with me.
This is what she came in with when they booked her. So if Paige's theory is right and we're dealing with a parasite and it's not in her, where is it?
Wait a second. What's that? Sand? Think that means anything?
Let's find out.
It's sand.
What kind of sand?
Sand. Sand.
Well, obviously, your 6 years of high school weren't wasted.
It's ordinary, everyday quartz, you know, mica, feldspar, magnetite.
Thanks for nothing.
Hey, I can only work with what I have.
Exactly.
Can we get this rolling, O'Malley? Some of us have a life.
What?
I had some luck. I found it on a friend.
There's no smoking in this building.
What are you gonna do? Arrest me for smoking?
No, but I could hold this blowtorch to your head.
Geez, O'Malley, you're sick. Only you would bring a blowtorch to an interrogation.
Coming from a parasite that feeds off the entrails of other living things, that left a bruise.
Hey, I have to do what I do. It's a biological necessity. What's your excuse?
Okay, can we table the personal animosity for a minute?
Okay, but just for a minute.
Where were you last night around 2 a.m.?
I was in Miami.
You were in Miami?
That's right. You have a problem with that?
Yeah, I do. How did you get there?
2 weeks ago, a flight attendant picked me up. I've been crisscrossing the country ever since. I got jet lag you wouldn't believe.
Well, maybe a Dramamine enema would help.
Carl, are you gonna let him talk to me like that?
Baby, my hands are tied. O'Malley's a psycho. Did I say that out loud?
I'm sorry it doesn't fit into your theory, but that's where I was.
Well, that's interesting. You being in Miami, us finding sand, and one of the victim's personal effects.
Why didn't you tell me you found sand?
Because we're the police, and we don't have to tell you everything. Don't do that. I just had lunch.
I know who you're dealing with.
Who?
How about a little quid pro quo?
How about I don't stick you in the microwave and push the popcorn button?
How about I don't tell you who you're dealing with and Mr. and Mrs. Normals keep committing crimes all over Chicago?
Good one, baby.
Okay, what do you want?
A little leniency in a pending case, an illegal entry on the night of June 23rd. Need more details?
No. Deal.
The link you're after is the Sandman. He takes bodies for joyrides, using their ids as the engine.
You've heard of an id, haven't you, O'Malley?
Yes, in your case, it's short for idiot.
You know, I happen to know about the Sandman, so back off, or I might get a little amnesia.
Okay, so whatever repressed urges someone may have, the Sandman acts them out?
He takes what's there and magnifies them a lot. Sandman's a thrill seeker. He starts out small and keeps upping the ante.
All right, how do we kill him?
Simple. Kill the person it's in.
Is he attracted to gnomes? Because I'm developing a plan.
That's funny. I got a fake lab with your name written all over it.
Is that the only way to kill it?
Unless you can get it to voluntarily leave the person, then he's as vulnerable as anyone else. Good luck doing that. He's smart. Doesn't stay too long in the same body. Can only move into somebody he has physical contact with when they're asleep.
So if the Sandman left her...
Her husband was asleep next to her.
Listen, Thursday night, maybe you, me, and about 130 of your friends could get together.
Don't tease me like that.
You know, I want to call my lawyer.
Why? We're not arresting you.
Well, am I free to go?
No.
Well, then you're arresting me.
No, we're trying to help your wife. We think she may be suffering from a virus. Cause her to do what she did.
Virus?
Yeah.
What kind of virus?
The bad kind.
So I'm being quarantined.
Exactly.
Oh. Wait a second. If it's a virus, why are you guys in contact with me?
Kate?
We've been vaccinated.
Yeah, we've been vaccinated.
Huh.
Oh. Yeah, go ahead. It's okay.
Hey, Scott. You gone postal yet today?
Day's still young.
Hey, did you hear about that mailman that was so overworked he hadn't cleaned his gun in 3 weeks?
Yeah.
absolutely positively gonna kick your ass.
Hey, baby. I had to put my hands there. How else was I gonna guess your weight? I was pretty close, wasn't I? Hello? Hello?
Hi, it's Dr. Kasakasin. It's Kate Benson. Hi. Hi. How are you? Good. I'm good. I was just between beating confessions out of suspects, and I thought I'd give you a call. Well, you know what? I had a great time, too. And I was actually sorry that it had to end, and I thought maybe we could have dinner tonight. Or really? Great. Great. So, okay. I'll see you at 7:30. Okay. Great. Bye. Hi. Did you get things squared away with the husband?
You took my advice, didn't you? You called Dr. Perfect.
Dr. Kousakis. I don't see how any of that is your business.
Kate.
What?
You're my partner, you know? We listen to each other. We rely on each other. Nothing wrong with you admitting that I was helpful to you when it came to a relationship issue. Look, if you'll admit I was right about calling him, I'll admit that you've been right about my inability to commit.
You were right about calling him.
And you were wrong about my inability to commit.
What?
You were wrong.
What?
Dead wrong.
Benson, O'Malley, in my office. What about your suspect, the husband?
After poking him, prodding him, and demeaning him in ways that men shouldn't be, Carl, the master of bad timing and armed robbery, let us know that he could tell if the Sandman was inside someone and that we had the wrong guy. We pretty much convinced him not to sue.
Making my job easier. That's a first.
When did you get back into town?
Like a week ago. Got settled in. Here I am. It's like I never left. Oh, and I got your Bears tickets. 50-yard line.
Nice.
Hi, I'm...
Cades. Heard a lot of good stuff about your work. And anyone that can keep Nick in check, I guess that makes you my new hero.
Thanks.
You're not gonna try charming me, are you?
No, sir. However, I do have one 8x10 photograph, personally signed, by Miss Diana Ross.
To Captain Page, with love. Diana? Well, I don't know what to say.
Well, how about welcome back? My God, you're wasting away. I gotta take you to lunch.
I'd like that.
None of this diet crap, okay?
Alice was the SU-2 damage control officer before she moved to L.A.
And Nick used to give me more work than any three officers in the unit.
I didn't know they had an SU-2 in Los Angeles.
No, I went out there to be an actress. I figured this job was perfect training. All I do is lie.
And you do it well.
All right, let's 86 the reminiscing. We're not working for Hallmark. We got an out-of-control mailman downtown at the Smith Building.
You think it's related to the Sandman?
Well, the mailman in question delivers mail to the housewife who robbed a convenience store, so either it's a coincidence of epic proportions, or the answer is yes. In either event, why don't you get on there and find out. Keep the press to a minimum.
Got it. I'm just gonna go slip into something uncomfortable. I'll meet you in the parking lot. Why can't they ever pick some out-of-the-way place? It's always gotta be in the middle of the daytime. Hey. You're from the Chicago Morning News. What are you writing there? Let's talk about it.
Love living life on the edge, don't you?
Yeah, we all do. Now, why don't you just take a step down and we could swap stories about how we've all cheated death, okay?
What if I don't? What are you gonna do, shoot me?
It's an option.
You're not gonna shoot an innocent man.
Every step you take towards me, I take one towards the street. By my count, that leaves one.
Nick.
He's bluffing.
Try me.
No, okay, come on. There's no rush. Okay, what do you want?
I want a party like it's 1999. What do you think it would feel like to swan dive off this roof?
Now, why would you want to do that?
Because I'm an adrenaline junkie and I need a fix. You should thank me for what I do.
Why's that?
Because I make life interesting. I pluck anonymous 9-to-5 robots from their boring existence and give them the thrill of their life. No limits, no lines, no rules.
Okay, maybe we can make a deal with this guy.
He's not interested in a deal.
You're right. What I'm interested in is pushing the envelope as far as it'll take me.
I know what I saw. I don't care what you say.
I'm not saying anything. I'm trying to help you out here. Just tell me exactly what you saw.
A guy in a postal uniform did a swan dive off the top of the Smith building. When he did, another guy came out from inside of him, hightailed it down the fire escape, while the mailman hit the pavement.
How many kids do you have?
Two. What?
How long have you been at your job?
11 years.
And that's the story you want to print, Chicago's largest daily newspaper. Tell you what. It's almost happy hour. This thing's gonna drag on for a while. How about you and me go across the street to Hanrahan's and do a couple of shots?
My Uncle Earl is gonna be waiting at the bus station because I can't call him on account of they got no phone. I mean, after the insurance money ran out on his black lung settlement, his wife got a job at Steela Stadium selling Iron City beer. And then she got fired when they caught her in the box seat of the 40-yard line watching the Dolphin game. Now, I've taken 3 days off to see if I can make their lives a little more comfortable, and no one around here can tell me when I can leave.
Let me ask you a question. Are the movie rights available to that story?
What?
Look, pal, this is official police business, so you can leave when we say you can leave. Now, why don't you grab some wood before I pull out my baton and beat you like a piñata?
You handled that well.
Well, you know, brothers in law enforcement, we gotta stick together.
Amen.
You know, I actually applied for the force once.
Oh, yeah?
Got rejected because I got a slow metabolism, but I've been hitting the gym, working on the guns.
We found Carl. He was out with the parasite.
Oh, you finally found someone to unpack your trouser luggage.
Jealousy is so ugly. And so are you.
That's one.
Okay, can we get this over with, please? Some of us have plans.
You have plans?
Why is that so hard to believe?
No reason. Okay. Have this guy look to his left and hold his right arm straight level to the ground. Nope, Sandman's not in him. Next.
Whoa. How do you know if the Sandman's inside somebody?
Sand gets in your joints. You can't look left and move right at the same time. Okay. All right, have him look to the left. Hold the right arm straight out, level to the ground. No. Next. Hey, boy. Think I can get some popcorn in a 12-pack?
That's two.
Yeah. Next. Oh. Bring that guy in.
Check.
I think we should take a closer look at him. And be careful.
Why don't you excuse us for a minute?
Yeah, you guys gonna administer a little street justice?
Is it that obvious?
Hey, Stan.
Stan? I don't know what you're talking about. My name's Roger.
Read this. Try losing the hat.
I'm
It's better now or before?
You're dead, Carl.
Okay, he's not who we're looking for. Get him out of here.
Quadrigas, give me the willies. They're always staring at you.
Yes, I'm fine. Thanks.
Right arm straight out, level to the ground. No, that's not him either. Next.
We almost through.
We've got 25 more to check. Kate, go on your date.
No, we're in the middle of an investigation.
No, we're gonna go through every passenger one by one. We got 16 cops inside. Every exit's covered outside. We're fine.
You sure?
I'm sure. That I'm going to parlay this into a major favor down the road somewhere.
Thanks.
Hey, don't forget what I told you.
I already have.
That thing with the ice cubes. I mean, I can explain it again if you want.
Hey, I do the thing with the ice cubes.
The one I'm talking about involves having an actual partner.
That's one.
Wow. I didn't know you smoked.
I thought I'd give it a try. Life too short.
Well, as a doctor, I would probably tell you that...
Got any scotch, doctor?
Yeah, I think. Are you feeling okay?
I feel... okay all over.
Our reservation's in 15 minutes, and if you want, maybe we can go over there now and get a drink there.
You got something stuck in your throat? I think I can help.
Have a look to the left and take your shirt off. What?
Stick to the business at hand.
I am. She's not even my type.
What, you can't deflate her and put her into a brown paper bag?
That's two.
Keep going.
That's it. That's everyone.
That can't be everyone.
What do you want me to do? That's what they said.
Well, they're wrong. There's no way he got out of here.
Maybe we should bring that blonde back in. She looks suspicious.
That's three. You've been yanking us.
What are you talking about?
You wouldn't know the Sandman from Superman. You're trying to dodge that armed robbery beef.
I get it. Blame the gnome because you let him get away.
There's no way he got out of here. No one's left the building.
Kate left the building. You told her she could go.
Oh, no.
You're not scared, are you?
Maybe a little.
A little is good. You liked that, didn't you?
Yeah.
You like when a woman takes control, don't you?
Yes.
Louder!
Yes!
Yes.
You know what the best part of being a cop is? Cops have their own handcuffs.
You know, maybe this is too much, too soon, too fast.
Too late. You're repressing, Ron. It's not good for you. You can be free with me. All those hidden desires, all those naughty impulses. You gotta let them out.
I don't really have any naughty impulses.
Oh, well, guess that just leaves it up to me.
How close are you?
2 minutes.
You're still alive when I'm done? You can tie me up.
12 stories up without a net. Nick, I'd love to stay and play, but there's so many things I want to do, and only one of them includes you. Call me. Ooh, nice car.
You want to take a ride?
Absolutely. By the way, nice ass. Woo!
Oh, thank God you got here. I don't know what would have happened.
I have a pretty good idea.
Who are you?
I'm Kate's partner.
She's insane. She's like Dr. Jekyll and Mr. Hyde. She was perfectly normal when we had lunch, and she's like Catwoman.
No harm, no foul. Okay, I gotta go.
You wouldn't believe the thing she said she was gonna do to me.
See your name in our reservations list.
Really? Well, you must have missed it. There it is. See it now?
We got a line on Kate. She's at La Terraza restaurant.
What is she doing there?
Having dessert.
Great for me.
I've had better.
Tell me you haven't wanted to take a swing at me.
I haven't wanted to take a swing at you.
Liar! Not being honest! Come on. Come on, I'll give you the first shot.
I know this isn't you.
Wrong. It is me. This is how I really feel. Careful, Nick. I know what you're thinking.
What am I thinking?
You're wondering what I'm gonna do next.
Lucky guess.
You're wondering how you're gonna stop me without killing me.
Another lucky guess.
You're wondering if I'll kill an innocent person just for the thrill of it.
All right. Nobody needs to kill anybody.
Sit down or you're dead! Be a lamb and give me a moment, okay?
Freeze!
It's okay. I'm with Special Unit 2.
Doesn't look okay.
Leave! Don't rain on my parade!
Let's go.
You know her?
Yeah, she's my partner.
Special Unit 2. I heard it the first five times.
We have jurisdiction.
Not in a hostage situation.
Check with your superiors.
What happened? Captain Page said she was having dessert.
Things got out of hand. She took hostages. The SWAT team showed up. We're having a little jurisdictional disagreement.
I have your commander on the line.
Yeah. Fine. It's all yours.
So did you make contact with Kate?
She hasn't answered the restaurant phone.
Look, I know you're gonna handle this, and I know you're gonna get Kate out safely, and I know you're gonna deal with the Sandman, but could you just try to minimize the damage?
That's my plan.
So you have a plan?
Well, don't jump to conclusions. Kate?
Nick, where have you been? I was starting to get lonely.
Let's talk.
Okay, how do you want to do this? You want me to give you my list of demands so you can tell me that you can't give them to me. Then I have to start shooting hostages. Or you want to pretend that you're considering my request while you get your marksman into position. Or you know what, maybe I should just start shooting hostages so you really take my request seriously while you figure out a way to kill me.
There's another way.
I'm all ears.
You tell me what you want, I get it for you, you release the hostages.
What do you think of my outfit?
I like it.
You don't think it's too trashy?
If you were going to a baptism, maybe. Why don't you tell me what you want, and I'll get it for you, and you can let everyone in there go home.
Okay, here's the short list. A helicopter, $2 million in large, unmarked, non-sequentially numbered bills, and a parachute. And none of that is negotiable.
Assuming I can get it. It's gonna take some time.
No problem. Oh no, it is a problem for the hostages. Because if I don't see a helicopter by 8 a.m., people start dying.
I'll see what I can do.
I know you will.
I got a request of my own.
Well, that's not the way it works.
I fly the helicopter, that's the deal, and it's not negotiable.
What if I refuse?
Then you're gonna die.
Hey, Nick. You already lost one partner. Be ashamed to lose another.
Was loaded with blanks.
What about the Sandman?
The parachute also blank.
You tricked it into killing itself?
Plan worked better than it did on paper.
Oh my. What the?
The important thing is, you're okay.
Meet a guy when you're single, in your 20s, and heavily armed?
You'll meet someone else.
Oh, really? Really? You think it'll be easy to meet another good-looking doctor who saves kids and their dogs from drowning, who sings the national anthem at baseball games?
Is he completely out of the picture?
I don't know. I don't know. Maybe I'm just misreading the signs. He sent me a restraining order.
You know, I have a friend who can eat his own weight in cocktail wieners.
Maybe after my grieving period's over.
It's probably the handcuffs that prompted the restraining order.
I don't know. I don't remember anything.
Right. You're repressing again.
I was doing some reading on Freud's theory of the id.
I didn't know Freud had a column in Jugs magazine.
It's interesting that when your id was unleashed, you smoked, you drank, you ate to excess. Your choice of wardrobe was, what's the word I'm looking for? Kinky. That's it. Yes, and your sexuality.
Wasn't me.
It looked exactly like you.
You really think a housewife's secret desire is to rob a 7-Eleven?
Yes, I do. Okay, maybe you're right.
Thank you.
You sure you don't want a bite?
I'm not eating for a month. Let me ask you something. I want you to be honest with me, okay? You really think I repress too much?
Yes.
But come on, you can be honest. Just tell me the truth.
Yes.
Can't believe my mother was right. She said if I became a cop that I'd scare men off and that I was destined to be single for the rest of my life.
Well, your mother's wrong. There's someone for everyone.
How do you know? How can you be so sure?
I'll tell you how I can be so sure. You're smart, you're attractive, you know how to handle a variety of weapons. You can pretend to be interested in sports when you have to be, and most of all, you got a good heart.
Give me that.
Next on Sci-Fi, The Twilight Zone. On the next all-new Ghost Hunters, welcome to the Trans-Allegheny Lunatic Asylum.
This really housed Charlie Manson.
What you experience here...
Was that, is there somebody here with us?
...may change your mind about ghosts forever.
I feel like we're being haunted. Do you hear that?
What the hell was that?
Ghost Hunters, all-new this Wednesday at 9 on Sci-Fi.
What do you think you're doing?
Shopping.
Yeah, well, you're gonna have to pay for all this stuff.
Hey, no problem. Just give me all the money in your cash register.
Are you nuts?
Do I look like I'm nuts?
Nope.
And I'd like a pack of Morley menthols. The hard pack. Honey, wake up.
What? What's wrong? What?
I just had the worst dream.
Uh-huh.
I didn't even tell you what the dream was. I robbed a convenience store. And then as I was leaving, I stole a red sports car.
Really? With a stick shift?
I think so. I don't know.
Could it have been a German car?
I don't know. I don't remember. Well, the point is...
Could it have been a Porsche?
Just forget about the car, all right? The weird thing is, I was with Shirley the other day, and we were having lunch, and we were talking about exciting things to do, and I jokingly said something about committing a crime, and... Well, that must be why I had the dream.
You're under arrest!
heard the screams, and I instinctively dove in. The water was so murky, I could barely see my hand in front of my face. I guess I just got lucky because I managed to save both boys and their dog from drowning, and then I administered CPR to all three. Then we took him to Children's Hospital. Well, not the dog, but
Right. That's
where I work. I specialize in prenatal heart surgery.
That's an incredible story.
I'm sure you have dozens of incredible stories.
Well, emphasis on the incredible part. So what's life like when you're not working at the hospital?
Well, when I'm not working, I donate time to Doctors Without Borders. You sure you don't want to try this? It's fantastic.
Oh, no. God, I'm positive. If I eat chocolate, I might as well just apply it directly to my hips. What?
I can't get over the fact that you're a police officer.
Why is that so hard to believe?
Well, most people wouldn't put police officer and beautiful in the same sentence. Oh my God, look at me. I'm talking the whole time. It's a typical first date. I apologize.
No. There's nothing to apologize for. Your
check's in. Did you have a small mixed green salad?
Yeah.
Okay, yours comes to $11.50. That was a joke.
City is in the middle of a crime spree. Common thread being the perpetrators are all normal people with normal jobs and no previous criminal history. Jonathan, you find that amusing?
No. Well, it's just that every time a so-called normal person gets arrested, when the reporters interview the neighbors, they always say he was a quiet guy who kept to himself, when statistically speaking, these quote-unquote normal people are 32% more likely to be pushy loudmouths who stick their noses in everyone's business.
Just yesterday, a CPA carjacked a minivan filled with rabbis. An 83-year-old grandmother bungee-jumped off of the Hancock building, and a Cubs fan was the victim of a drunken shooting by a player.
Not slamming Sammy.
Obviously, we're looking at some kind of parasitic link that takes control over the host body.
Do we know what kind of parasite?
Well, no.
Do we know how to contain it?
No.
Well, do we know how it moves from one person to the next?
No.
Well, then why is it obvious we're dealing with a parasite?
It's Jonathan's theory. It makes the most sense, and I'm going with it. This time. Now, all the crimes fit a pattern, except for one yesterday. A liquor store robbery where the suspect was described as being nearly 4 foot tall and seemed to know what he was doing.
4 foot one.
Carl!
I wasn't anywhere near there, sir.
Near where?
Wherever it is you're talking about.
I'm going to overlook that because we need your help on this case. We know you're friendly with the parasite community.
Professional courtesy.
Work your contacts, see what you can find. Carl, I don't want to have this armed robbery conversation again.
You and me both, sir.
Dismissed.
So, how was your lunch date?
He's amazing. Did I tell you he once sang the national anthem at a Cubs game?
Are you sure this guy's completely heterosexual?
That's so offensive.
Yeah, I know, and politically incorrect, but a valid question nonetheless. He's too perfect.
Yeah, I don't know. I kept waiting for the other shoe to drop. You know, he's married, he's emotionally unavailable, he's...
Gay?
No, he's not gay. How am I gonna have a relationship with someone? I can't even be honest about what I do.
Well, first you have to be honest with yourself.
What does that mean?
Nothing.
Oh, come on, you got something to say? Say it.
You know, you can be a little repressed at times.
Oh, okay. Unlike you, who doesn't have an urge or feeling that isn't acted on. I mean, you want to go to Mardi Gras for the weekend, you go. You want to take flying lessons, you take them. You want to go snowboarding in August, you figure out a way.
What's your point?
Well, that with me, that there are sides that you don't necessarily get to see. Okay, and for once, don't say what you're thinking.
Fine. So how did you leave it with Dr. Perfect?
I'm waiting for him to call.
I thought you liked him.
I do. I do like him more than anyone in a long time.
All right, this is what you need to do.
Oh, great. Coming from someone who's never had a relationship that's outlasted the expiration date on a gallon of milk.
Call him.
What?
I'm probably breaking all kinds of confidentiality agreements by telling you this, but men like it when chicks take control.
Chicks?
That's right, chicks. That's how we talk when you're not around. So if you really want to see Dr. Marvelous again, you'll call him. And don't tell him I told you to do this. I can get into all kinds of trouble with the Guy Guild.
The Guy Guild.
Remember, mum's the word.
You have to believe me. I'm innocent. I can understand why the police think I did it.
Well, they did have surveillance video from 6 different angles.
Did you feel okay when you went to bed last night?
I felt fine.
Did you do anything different? Eat anything different? Anything out of the ordinary?
Well, I did have a glass of wine after dinner.
You make physical contact with anyone other than your husband?
Nothing. I keep thinking I'm gonna wake up and this nightmare is gonna be over. I didn't do it.
For what it's worth, we believe you're innocent.
Thank you.
So listen, if you can think of anything you might have forgotten, any little detail, just give us a call, okay?
These are her belongings.
Thank you.
All right, come with me.
This is what she came in with when they booked her. So if Paige's theory is right and we're dealing with a parasite and it's not in her, where is it?
Wait a second. What's that? Sand? You think that means anything?
Let's find out.
It's sand.
What kind of sand?
Sand.
Well, obviously your 6 years of high school weren't wasted.
It's ordinary, everyday quartz, you know, mica, feldspar, magnetite.
Thanks for nothing.
Hey, I can only work with what I have.
Exactly.
Can we get this rolling, O'Malley? Some of us have a life.
What?
I had some luck. I found her on a friend.
There's no smoking in this building.
What are you gonna do? Arrest me for smoking?
No, but I could hold this blowtorch to your head.
Jeez, O'Malley, you're sick. Only you would bring a blowtorch to an interrogation.
Coming from a parasite that feeds off the entrails of other living things, that left a bruise.
Hey, I have to do what I do. It's a biological necessity. What's your excuse?
Okay, can we table the personal animosity for a minute?
Okay, but just for a minute.
Where were you last night around 2 a.m.?
I was in Miami.
You were in Miami?
That's right. You have a problem with that?
Yeah, I do. How did you get there?
2 weeks ago, a flight attendant picked me up. I've been crisscrossing the country ever since. I got jet lag you wouldn't believe.
Well, maybe a Dramamine enema would help.
Carl, are you gonna let him talk to me like that?
Baby, my hands are tied. O'Malley's a psycho. Did I say that out loud?
I'm sorry it doesn't fit into your theory, but that's where I was.
Well, that's interesting. You being in Miami, us finding sand, and one of the victim's personal effects.
Why didn't you tell me you found sand?
Because we're the police, and we don't have to tell you everything. Don't do that. I just had lunch.
I know who you're dealing with.
Who?
How about a little quid pro quo?
How about I don't stick you in the microwave and push the popcorn button?
How about I don't tell you who you're dealing with and Mr. and Mrs. Normals keep committing crimes all over Chicago?
Good one, baby.
Okay, what do you want?
A little leniency in a pending case, an illegal entry on the night of June 23rd. Need more details?
No. Deal.
The link you're after is the Sandman. He takes bodies for joyrides, using their ids as the engine.
You've heard of an id, haven't you, O'Malley?
Yes, in your case, it's short for idiot.
You know, I happen to know about the Sandman, so back off, or I might get a little amnesia.
Okay, so whatever repressed urges someone may have, the Sandman acts them out?
He takes what's there and magnifies them a lot. Sandman's a thrill seeker. He starts out small and keeps upping the ante.
All right, how do we kill him?
Simple. Kill the person it's in.
Is he attracted to gnomes? Because I'm developing a plan.
That's funny. I get a fake lab with your name written all over it.
Is that the only way to kill it?
Unless you can get it to voluntarily leave the person, then he's as vulnerable as anyone else. Good luck doing that. He's smart. Doesn't stay too long.